Many thanks for staying with us right here on eCentral. And joining me on eCentral is now two-time Grammy Award-winning producer, Eze Chisom Faith. Hey, we all know him as Rexy. First of all, Rexy, congratulations on your second Grammy.
Thank you very much.
I know it's coming right after your win in 2021. I mean, how does it feel 2 years back-to-back consecutively?
Feels good. Feel blessed, yeah. Feel blessed, basically. Yeah.
Well, you know, in 2021, you won for your contribution on Burna Boy's Twice as Tall album. And this year, you did it again on Angelique Kidjo's Mother Nature album. I mean, it feels like you now know how to produce those Grammy-winning albums. I mean, what does it take to be a Grammy-winning producer?
Just working hard and working right, you know, working smart and making the right plugs, basically. I don't know. Just working hard, I guess.
Wow. And I'm wondering, are there some elements you think should be added to our kind of production that we have this day? I mean, our sound, to make it sound even better and even compete favorably at the Grammy level? Or should we just continue producing what we do, I mean, doing what we do just right now?
Well, I feel we should infuse more African sounds to our music. Like, there's too much Afrofusion that will begin to sound like them, and they can't even differentiate if it's their sound or our sound. So we should be original, I guess.
Okay. Sure. Somehow we want to know or understand what exactly you mean by the right plug, as you just said seconds ago. What do you mean by the right plug to win the Grammys?
There's no plug. God is the plug. I guess. But I just mean, I just hustle, basically, like, you know, just get your works out there, give your sounds out to everybody, and don't be particular of where you want your sound to be, you know. So just hustle, basically, and God. There's the plug.
A little insight about how you worked with Angelique Kidjo. Did you travel to Benin Republic or some other part of the world, or it was done right here or virtually? I like to know.
Okay, what happened was this song was recorded 2020. Yeah, so what happened was, while I was recording for Twice as Tall, the song Do Yourself was one of the songs recorded that period. Then Burna Boy called me like 2021, and I was like, yo, Rexy, I'm about to give you another Grammy. And I was like, okay, all right. And then he called Angelique Kidjo and said, yo, this is the song we're singing. Boom. It's just like that.
Wow.
So shout out to Burna Boy.
And shout out to you, Rexy, for doing those magical touches on those songs.
Thank you.
A lot of persons have won the Grammys, yes. Africans have also won. But I'm sure you didn't miss out of the conversation going around Wizkid not winning for his Made in Lagos album or even for the song Essence. What do you think about how things played out at the Grammys?
I was expecting Wizkid to win. You know, if not the two, at least one. I expect him to win. So I guess it's a lesson for us. You know, we should explore more. We should understand that the world global music is not just, it's not African music, and we should try and push the African sound more, you know, so it gets global more. You know, so that's what it means. That's what it means to me, I guess.
Now, talking about the African sound, and away from the Grammys this time, you are credited for creating that sound called Zanku. What did you do? How did you come about that? How did you put that sound up together?
Zanku means Latin Abeg, you know, because it was created in an era where I was working with Latin and the likes, you know, that energetic street music where everybody just wants to dance and be happy. That was where Zanku came from, you know, making energetic music, expressive music, where you had the mixture of high, and heavy beats, you know. That was Zanku dance.
And then you gave us KPK. Now you're a singer-songwriter, you're a recording artist.
Yeah, I know, right? Beautiful.
That was quite beautiful. Anyway, finally, two Grammys under your belt. Locally, who are you looking at working with? someone you haven't worked with? And internationally, who do you have your eyes on?
This kid.
Wow.
I guess so.
What's stopping that? I mean, Wizkid is our Wizkid. What does it take to reach out to him or have that collaboration work?
I don't know, man. I don't know. Like, we're good friends. We talk, but musically we're not there yet, so I guess so.
And internationally, anybody?
It's a wide range from Chris Brown to Drake to... It's a long list. Yeah, let me just say Chris Brown and Drake.
Anyway, thank you so much, Rexy. Thanks for joining us today on East Central.
Thank you very
much. And we hope to catch you soon. All the best.
Thank you very much.
And that was two-time Grammy-winning producer Rexy right here with us on East Central. We have more stories coming to you shortly. Stick around. Thanks for staying with us right here on News Central. Of course, this is East Central, and we've been talking entertainment. Yeah, I mean, literally, because I just got you the Grammy-winning producer. Okay, let's move on to some of the gist right now. Today, Ed Sheeran won a high court copyright battle over his... Chokri, a London-born grime artist who performs under the name Sammy Switch, had claimed that the O-I hook in Ed Sheeran's track was strikingly similar to an O-Y refrain in his own track. Ed Sheeran said he did not remember hearing O-Y before the plea different. Oh, but the other argued that they contained significant similarities. Anyway, legal proceedings were launched in 2018, which resulted in an 11-day trial in London last month. And now, Ed Sheeran has been vindicated.
I feel like claims like this are way too common now and have become a culture where a claim is made with the idea that a settlement will be cheaper than taking it to court, even if there's no base for the claim. It's really damaging to the songwriting industry. There's only so many notes and very few chords used in pop music. Coincidence is bound to happen if 60,000 songs are being released every day on Spotify. That's 22 million songs a year, and there's only 12 notes that are available. I don't want to take anything away from the pain and hurt suffered from both sides of this case, but I just want to say I'm not an entity. I'm not a corporation. I'm a human being. I'm a father. I'm a husband. I'm a son. Lawsuits are not a pleasant experience. And I hope with this ruling, it means in the future, baseless claims like this can be avoided. This really does have to end. Me, Johnny and Steve are very grateful for all the support sent to us by fellow songwriters over the last few weeks. Hopefully we can all get back to writing songs rather than having to prove that we can write them. Thank you.
You're welcome, Ed Sheeran. Well, talking about Ed Sheeran and that song, especially Shape of You, that was the UK's best-selling song of 2017 and is Spotify's most streamed song ever. The song won the Grammy for Best Pop Solo Performance at the 60th Annual Grammy Awards. And talking about the song, that song is so sweet. Now, talking about something that will be so, maybe not so sweet, the next story is about a movie, a director, and a great expectation. Now, if you thought you saw some really disturbing and violent scenes in Netflix original series entitled Squid Game, then you just gotta hold your popcorn and some soda, cause Korean director Dong-Yong Kwon, who produced that series, is looking to top his own violent record. No violence in 2022, I thought. But hey, the 50-year-old says that he's working on a new film that will be even more violent than his acclaimed series, which set the record for being the most watched Netflix series. I think this new show should be perhaps PG-21 or PG-70, because Wang says that the controversial film will be an adaptation of Umberto Eco's novel entitled Killing Old People Club and might see him hide from old people when it is released. Just imagine. Well, I wonder who sits and writes a book about killing old people. I mean, they're eventually going to die. I'm not saying someone else should target young people in a new book. Well, we have seen all of that and enough of that. But one thing I'm going to bet on is that the director is most likely going to make a hit. Well, it may be all about the whole killing and the bragging, but hey, remember when he bragged about the first one? We saw how impressive that would be, but right now he is dropping another braggalicious one. We're looking forward to seeing that one right now. Moving forward, right now. Now, this is another story. This time around is all about the woods, but you know, this kind of wood that my woods and other woods can really kind of relate with. Come on, whatever I say, I'm just talking about while we're still exploring stage plays and theater and better storytelling, as well as a fancy sequel in Dubai. Hollywood is working on another sequel of action-packed movie franchise, Mission Impossible. You know what that, I mean, you know what that means? The world is about to experience another sequel to the action-packed movie Mission Impossible with leading man Tom Cruise, of course, reprising his role. And if he ain't broke, don't fix it. The 59-year-old Hollywood superstar who plays IMF agent Ethan Hunt in the blockbuster action franchise is believed to have hired 3 biplanes on Mission Impossible 8 for his stunts after learning how to fly a World War II plane, the 1943 Boeing Stearman Model 75 in the UK last year. The action star is said to be planning some of the biggest and most expensive stunts to date for Mission Impossible 8. Well, it would not be the first time the actor is playing big. I know, I've seen him. As you've seen, Cruise didn't come to play and he's not coming to play anytime. Well, I'm very sure that he gives his insurance company and agents sleepless nights. The man literally does all his movie stunts. So we're looking forward to seeing that movie. We're waiting for it. And I hear that he's got his own camp at Limpopo in South Africa. Mission Impossible 8 coming soon. And guess what? I have an amazing producer also joining me right now to talk in a bit. Stick around. Joining me now is music composer and producer Afe Mark Rock. Afe produces really beautiful covers. In fact, before we start talking, just watch this.
Only lovers, before the love came in, now you be soldier. General, no send me, now you de boss. Now where you no send me.
You tell me, send me not the type of girl where you really want. I am trying to be like other girls for you, but me still different from all that. Why you trying to compare me with all of them?
Welcome to East Central.
Day, day.
Nice to see you, man. How are you?
They actually named you twice.
Hallelujah,
I'm good.
Man.
I'm good.
You look good, you know.
You too, bro.
Fresh, man.
You here for me.
Okay, man. Let's start from very humble beginnings, as they say. You, how did it all start for you? Did you choose production or production chose you?
Okay, production chose me. I'm a computer scientist. I'm a network administrator, CCNP certified, Cisco certified. Mm-hmm. So along the way, I was writing some of my certification programs, professional programs, and music just came. I was acting too.
Oh.
Yeah, I was acting too. And back then, I'm just trying to, thinking, well, you know, back then, okay, you're just going to work in an office,
yeah.
Going to get employed, uh-huh. Gainfully employed. But then music just came, and then I just gave it a try, and then boom, we are here. Hmm.
And talking about you giving it a try, you started from church,
yes.
You started from gospel,
yes.
And all of a sudden you just switched to secular. How come, Baba?
The way you're putting it, it's not correct like that.
Okay, how did it go? Like that. How did it go?
Okay, so basically, I'm a professional music producer.
Okay.
I'm in the music space, in the gospel space, in the non-gospel space. So I thrive in every sector that has to do with music. So you know me say I come on church.
Oh, okay. So you do this, you do that.
Yeah, I do everything.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
And you also do inspirational songs,
sure,
basically.
Sure.
Now, talking about music production, imagine you're talking to a five-year-old. How does it work? Explain to me how you go about music production.
Okay. What am I doing? What am I saying to the five-year-old?
Probably, you know, the score, how to score music. Talk to me about it.
Okay. Let me see you as a five-year-old.
Yeah.
Okay. My son.
Mm-hmm.
You have to be patient.
That's another word.
Basically, music is storytelling.
Okay.
From the start, from the write-up, from the beginning of the composition, yeah, I'm taking you on a journey. You understand? So understand that, and then you've understood 50% of music composition, mm-hmm. and is storytelling. You understand? I'm taking you from zero. Just imagine watching a movie and then there's no soundtrack. That emotions, you are not going to feel it. So that's what music does, basically.
I'm talking about emotions. I mean, you you work with a lot of artists and you work with a lot of talent, and you are the master of these talents. I mean, I've listened to a whole of your sessions and they legit give me chills. How do you feel being right there, being the custodian of all these talents? How does it feel?
Well, first of all, I'm actually humbled, you know, being called what you're calling me. It's a big honor for me, because the truth is that I've also been there looking for where somebody's going to help me and discover me also, you get it? So being able to discover young talents, talented people that don't have a voice, it's humbling for me. It's quite a taxing job, because the truth is that Nigeria, in view, has so much of talent. Talent, everywhere.
You're right.
Everybody can sing, everybody can act, everybody can dance. Like everybody. So, you know, being able to now pick out those ones and refine them and then set them up for the global market, now that's where the technical part of the job comes in. Not as easy as we see it.
And talking about talent, I mean, you've worked with very big names. I've seen J1, I've seen Skills, Waje. But there are certain persons on your list you're still eyeing. I mean, people you've not worked with. Yeah.
The ones I've not worked with, I'm eyeing them.
Okay.
They're actually a lot, because I'm not celebrity crazy.
Okay.
I spotlight those people that are genuinely good, not because you have a name. You understand? So there are a lot of genuinely talented, world-class singers in Nigeria that can battle and rival any artist in the world. Now, those are those people I'm looking out for.
Any names?
Well, top of my list is Tiwa.
Hmm.
Yeah, top of my list is Tiwa.
Oh, because she's so beautiful.
Where?
I mean, beautifully, you know, musically beautiful.
With a good voice.
Amen. I know you have an album coming out.
Yeah.
Tell me more about that.
Okay, so I decided to collage all my content into something people can just listen, because I've been having offers. People are saying, Afa, give us something. And I'm like, okay, for 3 years I've been dragging leg. I've had content, like sessions close to 1,000, but I'm like, okay, let me dive into the streaming and the body of work market. So I'm putting up something. It's going to be out very soon, very soon, soonest. And, you know, for those that actually just want to calm down, you've had noise all through the day, you want something to cool you down, just stream.
Yeah. Fantastic. And we'll be looking forward to that. I just hope, you know, it comes out. It's going to hit the market.
We'll
definitely have you right here back.
I'm good.
Thanks a lot for coming around, man.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
God bless.
Thank you, Ife Rock. And I've been talking with an amazing producer right here in the city of Nigeria. And you better keep your eyes on him. Ife Rock is going to definitely take you all around the world. Be in Lagos, be in Nigeria, wherever you are in Africa too. We say big ups to you. Okay. Thank you so much for being a part of this show. It's been an amazing time, you know, bringing you producers, world-class winning producers, and of course, giving you all the entertainment gist you need to know. Don't forget that you can also join us on social media at News Central TV. Should I repeat? News Central TV. Catch you later. Have a beautiful day.